Hello everyone. Hope all of you are staying at home and enjoying perhaps. After all YouTube servings and books readings, I thought you must be bored. And as a teacher, I clicked upon an idea to share something with you. At present, we have interstate and international boundaries. Have you ever thought how people, basically the royal kings, protected their countries in the past? Yes, they had their own defense mechanisms in the form of forts. Has anyone been to the Shanivarwada in Shanivarpet, Pune? Exactly, you got my point. It is an example of fort. Now, I will take you to a digi tour of forts in India. Here we go.
What are forts? A fort is a place that's made strong and secure enough to be defended during a war. Pretty much interestingly, India is considered as a land of the forts.
Everyone loves facts, and so do I. There are approximately 1,000 or more forts in India. Some of the famous ones that one should visit here are Amber Fort, Mehrangarh Fort, Jaisalmer Fort, and much more. Maharashtra reportedly has the highest number of forts. Okay, but what's so interesting? Well, it's just that no one, literally no one, knows the exact number. Forts of India are famous for their style, design, and material used. Building materials. The materials used for constructing forts differ from region to region. The walls of these forts were very thick and, of course, very tall. Stone was the most important material for building these walls.
Nevertheless, Indian forts indeed had majestic gates. They were truly the architectural and engineering marvels of forts. Nonetheless, who doesn't like a refreshing garden to relax after a tiring day? The verandas and/or balconies often overlook the enthralling gardens.
As I already said, Maharashtra has the highest number of forts, and they have got real fame. Maharashtra, a state with a rich history, includes some stunning forts that stand proud. For instance, the Shivneri Fort, Tikona Fort, and the Sihagad Fort.
Our first destination is the Shivneri Fort. This is the birthplace of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, the greatest Maratha ruler. It also houses Buddhist caves, a mosque built in Mughal architectural style, and a small temple of Goddess Shivai. How secular! The second stop is the Raigad Fort. Here lay the remains of the combatant conqueror Shivaji Maharaj. Along with him lay his dearest pet dog, Vaghya. Our next destination is the Murudjanjira Fort. It lies off the coast and somewhat looks like an island. The boat journey to reach it is phenomenal.
The largest fort in India is the Chittorgarh Fort in Rajasthan. The history of Chittor, its capital Mewar, and its fort is one of the most stirring chapters in Indian history. Covering an area of 691.9 acres, it is regarded as a symbol of Rajput chivalry, resistance, and bravery. Another interesting fact is that, from a bird's eye view, the fort's structure resembles that of a fish. The oldest fort in India is the Pride of Himachal Pradesh. This is yet another Rajput achievement. Despite withstanding 52 attacks from various clans and dynasties from various parts of the subcontinent, it surrendered to nature's wrath. A provocative certainty, majorly regarded as a factful myth, is that even after Sultan of Ghazni looted 8 treasure wells, the British discovered 5 more in the 1890s. Interesting. We have our armed forces ready at the borders to combat any invasion. The rulers then had nothing apart from infantry, cavalry, and of course, forts. In fact,
the capturing of forts was the most important war strategy. A mentionable role is played by the Archaeological Survey of India, which maintains and renovates these historical heritage sites. Apart from the ASI, we, as the citizens of India, and also the educators of the next generation, must preserve these wonderful structures.
At last, we have returned. I hope you all enjoyed this educational trip. I too enjoyed with all of you. See you, bye children. See you next time with another interesting educational tour. Until then, bye-bye. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye children.